Something's there. Let's take a break.
Kong was the son of a village chief, but like the others, he was a second son and had been raised as a spare ever since childhood. However, Kong was unable to sit back quietly and accept the role of a secondary human like the others.
Take this! You're fine! Give it up! You're fine! It's down! Take! It's down! Give it up! You're fine! It's down! Take! It's down! Give it up! Give it up! You're fine! You're fine! Take this! It's down! Take this! Take this!
Treasure chest!
It was truly a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity that had fallen into his lap. Most importantly, Moro's appearance was going to fight your teeth. Regardless, it was clear that if he went about his plan head-on, Moro would reject him. The fact that Gon decided to try a more subtle approach without hesitation showed how twisted he truly was. We went through all that trouble of smashing the carriage, too. Better take our time repairing it tomorrow. Gon grinned with joy at the thought of tomorrow night. The next morning arrived without incident, despite the fact that uninvited company had arrived the day before. So far, Gon and his gang had kept their promise, avoiding contact with the village and focusing on the repairs of their
horse
carriage.
This is...
Since that was the case, the villagers had gone out of the forefront of their minds. Although they had passed the peak of the harvest season, there was still plenty of work for all the villagers to do. They had to start preparing large amounts of food to be reserved for the winter, and products had to be prepared to be taken to the capital, too. Because of this, the villagers had been bustling about electricity since early
morning.
By the time noon had passed, they had completely forgotten their weariness.
they come!
Take it off!
Get it off!
Come on!
Take it off!
Here's...
This is...
If the villagers had witnessed this, their eyes would have grown to the size of